welcome to RTC TV4. My name is Aubrey Degg, and I'm here at Casson High School, getting ready for an exciting evening of high school volleyball. It is September 22nd, and tonight's matchup is between the Casson Comets and the West Central Trojans. We are here getting ready for the opening serve. And number 25, Bailey Schultz, will be our first server for tonight. Tonight's starting five for the Casson Comets is Bailey Schultz, Miranda Sanderson, Megan Evans, Kayla Gearhart, Nicole Greener, and Kennedy Ault. The first point of the night goes to the Trojans. The Comets starting off the game with a bang. Trojans have three so far, and the Comets have zero. There's been so far a lot of out of bounds plays. Let's see if the Comets can get their first point in. And they did it. Their first point of the night. And our server will be number 9, Nicole Greener. And a failed jumped out of spike, giving it the Comets point, and Nicole Greener is still our server. Saved by the Comets. And that's out of bounds. Spiked out of bounds. And it's the Trojans' point. And our server for the Trojans will be number 2, Amanda Saltzman. A dig from Miranda Sanderson and a save by Kennedy Ault. Kennedy Ault tipping it right back over the net before they can get a spike up. Kennedy Ault is also our server for today. Nice quick save. But point still going to the Trojans. Trojans tipping it right over the net, right over our block. No one behind her to back her up, so it's the Trojans' point. Number 11, Kenzie Boeing, is our server. Emily Rowe tipping it right over the net. Trojans coming in for a spike and point. Point for the Trojans, giving the Trojans 7 points, and the Comets have 3. A hard serve from the Trojans. Yeah. the ball is up. Over, and a set by Bailey Schultz. And a spike from Miranda Sanderson. Bailey Hook is our server for tonight. She is number 8 on the court. And it was almost a touch by the Trojans, but it was tipped out of bounds by Miranda Sanderson. So now the Trojans ball, and our server is number 6, Kelsey Carpenter. Great dig by Kennedy Ault, saving the ball. The Comets being able to return it. Megan Evans going for that dig. A little bit of miscommunication between two of our girls after Megan Evans got the dig. Timeout called by the Comets. Earlier this evening, the junior varsity team played the Casson Comets, winning a great game. The Trojans won one round, and the Comets pulled out with the two other rounds, pulling out with a win. Coming out of this timeout, it is the Trojans ball. Number 6, Kelsey Carpenter, is still our server. Now both teams are broken out, and the game is back in session. And a set in a tip by the Trojans. And that's the Comets point. There was a touch to the net by the Trojans. And it is Megan Evans' serve. Set, and another set by the Trojans. Another touch to the net, making it again the Comets ball. And the block by the Comets. Spike by the Trojans. Almost out of bounds, but there was a touch by Megan Evans. Now it is the Trojans ball, and number 4, Katie Culp, is our server. Out of bounds by Miranda Sanderson. Again, the Trojans ball. The Trojans now have 13 points, and the Comets have 7. The ball is up. Really good serve by the Trojans. Right over the net. And another spike by the Trojans. And another touch by Megan Evans. and the ball's up. And this time it is out of bounds with no touch, making it the Comets' ball. Number 11, Miranda Sanderson, is our server. Comets going for that dig, trying to get it up off the floor after a set over the net by the Trojans. Couldn't quite keep it up off the ground, making it the Trojans' ball. Number 1, Peyton Beiswanger, was our server. Another Comets ball, another touch to the net, and a double hit. It is Bailey Schultz's serve. Miranda Sanderson going for that dig. Not quite getting it up. And that's a spike by Kennedy All. Kennedy bringing it back with her spikes. Hard and vicious they are. Hard to return. Number 2, Amanda Saltzman, is our server for the Trojans. It did jump serve, she's used. Quick save by the Comets after a set out of bounds and another spike by the Trojans. The Trojans definitely have gotten a lot of points from their spikes tonight. Majority of their points have been from spikes, and hopefully the Comets can begin to calculate where those are going and heading. But for right now, we got a spike for the Comets by Kennedy Ault. Kennedy Ault is also our server. After a very, very long play, it goes to the Comets. Comets now with 12 points and the Trojans with 18. Kennedy All is still our server. Kennedy serve just nicked the net, going back onto the Comets side. Number 11, Kenzie Bone, is our server, or was our server. Bailey Hook is our server. Another surprise set over the net by the Trojans. A lot of their sets at the net surprise the Comets because they look like they're going for the spike, except then they switch mid-jump and get set. Number 6, Kelsey Carpenter, is our server for the Trojans. And Miranda Sanderson tipping it over the net, and it is the Trojans' ball, though. There was no touch, and it was out of bounds. A nice save by Bailey Schultz. And out of bounds set by the Trojans, making it the Comets ball. Comets now have 14 points, and the Trojans have 22. Megan Evans, number 0, is our server. Nice block by Nicole Greener, giving the Comets another point. Perfect block, sending it straight back down to the ground, almost like it was a spike. Another block by Nicole Greener. And there's a timeout for the Trojans. So far, a very recognizable face right now is definitely Nicole Greener. She's had 3 blocks so far, and the score is Comets with 16 and Trojans with 22. It is still the Comets ball. Megan Evans is still our server for the Comets. Ball not quite making it over the net after a bump by Nicole Greener. It is now the Trojans' ball. Number 8, Adriana Barlow, is our server. Kayla Gerhardt going for that dig, and it is returned by Kennedy Ault. Another block by Nicole Greener, giving the Comets another point when there was a hold. Miranda Sanderson is our server. Comets now have 17 points, and the Trojans have 23. The Trojans only need 2 more points to win this game. And a great, great spike from Kennedy Ault. Straight down, right on the line. Just enough in bounds to be counted in. Miranda Sanderson, still our server. And the ball is out of bounds, giving the Comets another point. Comets coming up and catching up to the Trojans. There's still hope for everyone, isn't there? Because Comets now have 19 and the Trojans have 23. Miranda Sanderson's ball is going right over the net, nicking the net, appearing to be a net ball, but going right over and getting her 2 points for the Comets. Comets now have 20 and the Trojans have 23. comments earlier were definitely down more, and they have definitely made a very, very big comeback. I feel as though they can come back out of this. I mean, the Trojans are only leading by 3 points. It is still the Comets' ball. And her server is still Miranda Sanderson. And the game is back on. Miranda Sanderson serving, and the ball's up. This time not quite making it over the net, just short of the net. It is now the Trojans' ball. This is the first match point of this round. Timeout called by the Comets. Children's ball coming out of the timeout. Number 9, Clarissa Blackburn, is our server. And the first round is won by the Trojans. The score is 20-25. Comets with 20 and the Trojans with 25. And as the team switch sides for the next round, the Comets can definitely come back. And this is played out of 5 games, so whoever wins 3 out of the 5 wins overall. And Comets can definitely come back with this. There's plenty of time to make up for what they've lost. And, you know, they haven't lost much. I mean, there was only 5-point difference between the two scores at the end. And they can definitely come back from this, as long as they don't get too down themselves. At the beginning of the game, though, the Comets had a hard time making the points. The ball wouldn't go over the net. It went out of bounds. A few communication, just that wouldn't go through correctly. And, you know, by the end of the game, they were working good, working hard. But by then, it was just kind of too late. But hopefully, we can start off strong at the beginning and stronger at the end. And for this second round, the Trojans are coming back out of their huddle. And it appears to be the Comets' ball. The Comets coming back out, ready for this second round. our starting lineup for this second game, or second round, is Kennedy Ault, Nicole Greener, Bailey Schultz, Kayla Gerhardt, Megan Evans, and Miranda Sanderson. It is the Trojans ball, and number 7, Jaden Hudson, is our server. The comments already starting off with a few miscommunications here and there. Still smiling, still going after it, getting back to their spots, getting ready to position. Another point for the Trojans is the ball was out of bounds. Trojans coming out of this for the second round very, very strong, already up by 3. Comets still holding on. I mean, once you get ahead by so many points, it's hard to make up, but it is definitely doable. Impressive set spike by Kennedy Ault, throwing the Trojans off guard, and nobody behind him to back him up, so goes to the Comets for their first point for the second round. Another point for the Comets. Bailey Schultz is our server. And the point goes to the Trojans. Out of bounds ball, and it is now the Comets serve. Nicole Greener is our server for the Comets. And the ball is over. And sent back by the Trojans. Another point by Kennedy Ault. And the score is now tied 4-4. Another point for the Comets. Trojans spike not quite making it over the net, more into the net. And it is still Nicole Greener's serve. And it is the Comets ball, almost a touch, not quite though. Comets caught it before it could go into play. For today's game, I would like to recognize the line judges. The line judges are Sydney Moon and Sydney Klinger. Both of those young ladies play for the junior varsity team here at Caston High School. Both teams are broken out, and it is still the Comets ball. Comets have pulled ahead 6-4. Ball's up. And point to the Trojans. Ball went on the other side, not over the net, but around the side, and Leila Schultz had an attempt to return it, crossed over to get it. But Bailey Schultz again going for the ball. Ball this time not quite going where she needed to go to be able to get a bump or a set, and it went too close to the net. And any attempt to get it would have touched the net, so it would have been a bad play anyway. Comments. It is Kennedy Alt's serve. Kennedy Alt is number 10. And the ball remained in bounds, making it the Trojans' ball. The score is now tied 7-7. And the Trojans serve in number 6. Kelsey Carpenter is the server. And that is out of bounds. Comments ball. Comments again, tying it 8-8. And the server for the comments is number 8, Bailey Hook. It is now the Trojans' ball, number 8, Adriana Barlow. Bailey Schultz again saving the ball from the out of bounds. This time getting it away from the net. And a tip over the net. And it is the Trojans' point once again. The Trojans have now pulled ahead by 10-8. Spike by the Trojans, making it the Comets ball. Number 10, Kennedy All, is our server for the Comets. And they have now switched to Megan Evans as their server. And a soft serve from the Trojans. A nice dig from Kennedy Yall and a beautiful save by Megan Evans. Nicole Gruner going for the spike or tip and got it caught up in the net. Most sports you get caught up in the moment. Volleyball, it's caught up in the net. Three, That was an out-of-bounds play by the Trojans, making it the Comets ball and point. And number 11, Miranda Sanderson, is her server. The ball rolling down the net and onto the Trojan side. The Trojans not able to return it. The Comets have now pulled ahead by 1 point. Comets now have 12 and the Trojans have 11. And a spike by the Trojans. Kennedy out going for the block and it landing out of bounds. It is now the Trojans' ball. Number 7, Jaden Hudson, is our server. And the ball is inbounds. Comets ball. Number 25, Bailey Schultz, is our server. A nice save by Megan Evans from a spike. And it goes to the Comets. A spike by Kennedy Yule. Bailey Schultz is still our server. Comets have pulled ahead 14-12. Another great block by Nicole Greener and Kennedy Yule. And there's a timeout called by the Trojans. So far, the Comets have played a very good game. The Comets are so far leading 15-12. The Comets are definitely pulling out a lot stronger. The start of the game was a lot better than the last one. This time they're actually communicating a lot better and working together more as a team. There's only been a few miscommunications here and there. And a lot of it is the spikes from the Trojans that they can't quite get back up off the ground. But other than that, they're doing very, very well. It is still the Comets ball, and number 25, Bailey Schultz, is our server. And two digs in a row, one by Miranda Sanderson and another by Bailey Schultz. There was a touch to the net by Kennedy Yule when she spiked the ball, making it the Trojans' point. Now that is the Trojans' ball, number 13. Cassie Wuthrich is our server. And that is a point to the Trojans. Would have been out of bounds, but Megan Evans saved it. And, you know. Megan Evans saving the ball once again. And the Trojans having a little bit of miscommunication there and giving the Comets another point. It is Nicole Greener's serve. That's a save by the Trojans and the Comets. Once again, not being able to get the spike over the net. It's okay, the Comets are still leading by one. The Comets have 16 and the Trojans have 15. The server for the Trojans is number 11, Kenzie Boning. Boeing. And that is an out of bounds, giving the Comets another point. Comets pulling ahead by two. Comets now have 17, and the Trojans have 15. Kennedy Alt is our server. Trojans not being able to save the ball from out of bounds, giving the Comets another point. Comets definitely pulling ahead and feel as though they can win this now that they have some points on them. And that serve was out of bounds. It is the Trojans' ball. Number 12, Madison Schultz, is our server from the Trojans. Another save by Megan Evans, and not quite over. It is still the Trojans' ball. A quick save by the Comets. And that was Miranda Sanderson tipping it right over the net, getting us another point for the Comets. It is now Bailey Hook's serve. Trojans just saving the ball. Pass up by Bailey Schultz, a little bit too far, and not quite making it to the right spot for Miranda Sanderson to spike it. It is now the Trojans' ball, number 4. Katie Culp is our server. Again, another soft spike by the Trojans, giving the Comets another point. Comets now have 20 and the Trojans have 18. Megan Evans is our server. Communication between the line judge and the official, but it goes to the Trojans. The Trojans now have 18. And number 1, Peyton Beiswinger, is her server. Spike by the Trojans, tying the game with the Comets. Comets at 20 and the Trojans at 20 now. Both teams definitely now feeling the pressure. Being tied at such a high score is definitely scary. And the Trojans pull ahead by 1 point. Trojans with 21, Comets with 20. The timeout called by the Comets. Well, so far, the Trojans have definitely made a major comeback. They were down by quite a bit, and now they are 1 point ahead of the Comets. They only need 4 more points to win this round. And then they would have won 2 rounds, and they'd only need 1 more win to win the entire game. But the Comets they still have hope. They can still pull ahead. The Trojans made up that time, so can they. And both teams are back in, and it is the Trojans' ball. Number one, Peyton Beisinger, is still our server. Trojans now pulling ahead by 2 points. There was a really hard spike and just serve. Not quite getting it back up off the ground. That ball was just short, and, you know, there's a major, something noticed in the comments is set up is there's a major gap between the back row and the front row. I mean, they've spaced themselves out more now. The ball once again landing right in bounds, giving the Trojans another point. This is the match point for this round. The Comets have 20, and the Trojans are now at 24. And to top off this round was a hard serve from the Trojans. Trojans definitely bringing in the good servers. I mean, balls go straight to the target, straight to the middle. They know the weaknesses, and they've pinpointed them throughout the game of where to spike the ball, where to serve the ball, and they definitely brought out those places for the Comets. The Comets still have hope. I mean, there's still three more games that they could play, and hopefully they can pull through with that. The Comets definitely started off a lot stronger this game. The Trojans just happen to be a little bit stronger, being able to pull through with the win. And let's see if the Comets can do this.
How long is it going to be? I don't know how to control that. No, like the editing stuff, I just send them the film. Maybe I don't know what they're going to do with it, so it's a surprise to me, honestly.
Yeah.
For this game, I would like to recognize the superintendent, principal, athletic director, head coach, and JV coach for the Trojans. The superintendent is Don Street, the principal is Pat Cole, and the athletic director is Wes Allen. The head coach for the varsity is Kelly Dickenshutz, and the JV coach is Tanya Wall. The Trojans are actually a part of the Hoosier North Athletic Conference. So if the Comets win tonight, they will be one step closer in beating the Trojans for conference. Now for the Lady Comets. The coach is Melinda Schultz. The assistant coach is Rick Schultz. Manager is Hannah Pelmer. The superintendent is Mrs. Cindy Douglas. The principal is Chuck Evans. The athletic director is Blake Mullenkoff. And the administration intern is Jen Lukens. The Comets coming back into this game. It is the Comets serve. And the first server for the Comets will be number 25. The setup, the starting five for this round will be number 25, Bailey Schultz, Miranda Sanderson, Megan Evans, Nicole Greener, Kennedy Alt, and Kayla Gearhart. And the first point of this round goes to the Trojans. Number 7 for the Trojans is Jaden Hudson, and she is our server. Megan Evans getting it up off the ground, but Kayla Gearhart not quite getting her footing and running into the ball, not getting that bump that she needed. Oh. A good save by Kennedy Yall, but spiking it out of bounds. And after a long play, the Trojans get the point. Pumas definitely are moving all around. As you saw in that one, they were running all over the place. People are falling on the ground, getting back to their spots. And they were definitely working their hardest to be able to get that point. And it just turns out that that point wasn't for them. And let's hope this one is. And it was. The Comets now have 1 point. The Trojans have four. It is Nicole Greener's serve. And luckily for the Comets, the Trojans had a little bit of a miscommunication, getting the Comets one more point. Nicole Greener is still our server. Trojans getting that next point. It is now number two, Amanda Saltzman. Serve. Miranda Sanderson saving the ball. And a spike not making it back over the net by the Trojans. It is now Kennedy Yall's serve for the Comets. The score is now Comets with three and the Trojans with six. Beautiful serve by Kennedy Yall. Very hard, very straightforward. And the ball hitting the ground just before Bailey Schultz can get it up off the floor. Another point for the Trojans. Getting the ball, hitting the floor just before they get to it. So it appears like they've hit it, but it definitely hit the ground first. It is not still the Trojan serve, number 11, Kenzie Bonings, our server. The ball landing just on the line. It is the Trojans' point still, and ball. And there is a timeout called by the Comets. Comets are definitely playing hard, definitely moving their feet. And, you know, the Trojans are definitely not taking off any pressure. If anything, they're adding it. The Trojans are having a lot of really good serves and spikes, and there's definitely a lot of teamwork going on, a lot of calling. And something the Comets need to work on is probably calling out. There's been a few miscommunications here and there that really could have been prevented, but, you know, it just happens. And sometimes you just can't help it when they're running towards each other and just the heat of the moment. The Comets can definitely pull out of this. I mean, it's only 3-8, and the Comets can do this. It is still the Trojans ball, and number 11, Kenzie Boning, is still our server. Yeah! Chochin's over jumping that one, trying to go for the spike, it just being too high out of reach. And not quite making it over the net, so it is now the Comets ball. And Bailey Hook is our server. Another point for the Comets. Comets now have 5 points and the Trojans have 8. Another point for the Comets. Comets only down by 2. Children still have 8, and the Comets now have 6. Bailey Hook is still our server. Little miscommunication between the Trojans, but the Trojans still returning the ball. And the Comets returning the ball, and the Trojans not getting it over the net, so it is now the Comets' point. Comets now have 7 points, the Trojans have 8. Comets definitely making a comeback. Another point for the Comets to tie up the game. Trojans are definitely starting to feel the heat and the pressure of this game. And it is now a timeout. But yeah, the Trojans are definitely feeling pressure. They're not working together as normally as they do. I mean, their spikes are bad. Everything's just slowly falling apart as they get more and more nervous about this game. Well, the Comets definitely becoming more strong. I mean, they're realizing they can still do this. I mean, there's still 2 more games to be played, and they can still make a comeback. And now it's just based on who has the endurance and the strength to play and finish out this game. It is still the Comets ball. And number 8, Bailey Hook, is our server. Trojans coming back with a point. It is now the Trojans' ball, number 12. Madison Schultz is our server. The Trojans appear to come out of timeouts stronger than they were originally. I don't know what they do in the timeout. I mean, maybe they cheer each other on. Maybe they just feel more energized when they come back out, but they definitely play a whole different game when they come back out of a timeout. And they're definitely proving that, keeping the Comets running. I mean, both teams are constant back and forth motion. And I'm not as bad as that one. Ooh, Kennedy Ault taking the hard hit for that one. And it paid off. It is the Comets' point. Comets again tying up 9-9. Kennedy definitely took a hard hit for that one. Nearly the face, hitting her right in the neck, chest area, and just you could hear the impact, and surprising how little she flinched. Megan Evans trying to go for that save for an out of bounds hit and just not quite getting there in time. And it happens. Those happen quite a bit. It is still the Trojans' ball. Number 9, Clarissa Blackburn, is our server. Banging back her tips, tying the game once again. Nicole Greener should be a waitress. She gets a lot of tips. Miranda Sanderson not quite getting the serve. She needed, not the right height, is going under the net, not quite over the net. That's okay, the Comets are only down by 1 point. They can come back from this. It is the Trojan serve. And they did it, tied once again. The Comets have 11 and the Trojans have 11. Bailey Schultz, number 25, is our server. A Trojan taking the hard hit for Kennedy Yall to serve. Kennedy Yall getting into that spike she needed for another point. The Trojans' point. The score is once again tied 12-12. Both teams definitely bringing the heat. No one can really just level the scale right now. I mean, keeps on one ahead, then they tie, then another one ahead, and you know, it's very even right now. The competition is very great right now. Kennedy Yall trying to go for that spike, getting it more into the net and rolling back, and now it is the Trojans' ball. And that is an out-of-bounds play. It is still the Trojans' ball. The Trojans have now pulled ahead by 2 points. The Trojans have 14 and the Comets have 12. A little miscommunication. I mean, Trojans definitely having a great deal in that miscommunication. There was a tip. I mean, kind of y'all close to the net and somebody right beside her. And another that just, the ball not going in the direction they needed to go. And so now there is a timeout called by the Comets. I mean, the ball is just not quite going where they need it to go at this moment. You know, it's seeming to almost work oppositely. I mean, they were strong at the very beginning, and now it's just kind of fading away. You know, they're feeling the pressure once again, kind of like the Trojans did. And like the Trojans, hopefully they can pull ahead once again and win this round and then get two more wins to win the entire game. Coming out of this timeout, it is the Trojans' ball. Number 7, Jaden Hudson, is still our server. giving comments another point. Comments only down by 3. Bailey Hook going for that save, not quite getting it up high enough into anybody else's reach. The real struggle is when it starts, it's right on the edge of whether it's on your side or the other opponent's side. And so it's just kind of an iffy situation of who should tip it, who's going to hit, who's gonna make the move. And out of bounds, it is the Commons ball. Kennedy Hall is now our server for the Lady Comets. Judge is not quite making it over the net. The Comets making a comeback. Comets now are only down by 2, and the Trojans remain at 17. Comments now 16, and it is the timeout called by the Trojans. Comments definitely making a comeback. I mean, there's definitely no way, you know, progressively getting there. Sometimes the Trojans get that spurt of, you know, a lot of points, and then the Comments come back, hopefully with even more points. I mean, pulling out with a win. And hopefully they can do this. Out of this timeout, Kennedy All is still our server for the Comets. It was almost the Comets' point there. I mean, there was a block set by the Trojans, and it worked. They blocked it right into the middle of the court. Nobody was quite ready for that on the Comets, and it's now the Trojans' ball. And returned right back to the Comets. Ball failed to make it over the net. The Comets are now only down by 1, and the Trojans have 18. Now the Trojans ball once again. Trojans now up by 2. Trojans have 19 and the Comets have 17. A beautiful save for the Comets. I mean, Trojan hit the ball as soon as it was about to go out of bounds. And she ended up hitting it out of bounds, giving the Comets a point. Comets are now only down by 1 point. Megan Evans is our server. Very, very powerful spike. Too powerful at that, but it was still very, very powerful. Hitting dead of the core, it hit the back of the doors. Another point for the Comets. Comets now have 19, and the Trojans leading by 1 have 20. Our server is number 11, Miranda Sanderson. Kennedy, I'm not quite getting that tip in. Her fingers kind of went too far downward to bring the ball instead of out a little bit more than she needed. Took it, the ball straight down. And the Trojans pull ahead. Trojans have 22 and the Comets remain at 19. It is the Trojans ball. Number one, Peyton Beiswinger is her server. And the Comets get the point for that one. Comets now only down by two, but the Trojans are almost to the win. Hopefully the Comets can pull ahead by then. It is now the Trojans' ball. Definitely putting up a fight for this one. Working hard for it. They're moving, they're getting there. Megan Evans definitely making a difference. Intensity of that moment was very unreal. This is the first match point after that. Trojans finally got that point down. I mean, very, very long play that was. And that's a game. The Comets played very, very well tonight. They had a lot of very long plays that they just couldn't get the ball. And, you know, sometimes they pulled out with the point, other times not quite getting there. The Comets definitely did very good tonight. Just couldn't keep it down. I mean, some of their serves quite didn't make it over the net. And, you know, it's just a lot of different things that went into this game. But they all did very good tonight, and the Trojans also did well. And the Comets will play next on September 26th versus North Miami at 5:30. And thank you for tuning in to RTC TV4. Visit our website, www.rtc4.com, for more videos. Once again, I am Aubrey Degg. We will see you next time on RTC TV4.